I'm at a point with space games where I need more input than just the bare minimum with joysticks. The next step for me is head tracking. And I was thinking about all the different options that I got, but there are either very expensive options that require you to wear or have specific hardware to use them. And there are other options which are maybe free, but lack options. And I wanted to see if there is some way of a middle ground. And I think I found one today where I can just simply use my webcam that is already there. And we are going to talk about the Beam Eye Tracker. Full disclosure up front, Eyewear Tech is sponsoring this video, the company behind Beam Eye Tracker, but they're not getting to change my opinion about it. Well, you're maybe asking, why going with a software that requires just a simple webcam instead of going with something high value, high end, that is maybe suited more for the, you know, the task or whatever I am using? Well, it's simple because I wanted a solution that is not only applicable for me that gets the stuff sent, but also applicable for you for as little as $30 or 30 euros at the moment recording this video. And the only thing you need on top of that is a webcam, which does not need to be a new one or an expensive one or whatsoever. You can get a used one for like 10 bucks or something off from eBay for your entire eye and head tracking. And here's the kicker: eye and head tracking. I'm going to talk about that in a second. And then on top of that, if you don't want to get a webcam, or you can't, or whatsoever, but you have a phone in your pocket, then guess what? You can also use your phone and use that as a webcam replacement. And I'm going to do that live in this video for the first time. Try to use my telephone as a replacement for the webcam. If you already sold and you're like, yeah, I want to grab that, this is exactly what I was looking for, there's an affiliate link to their website in the description, and there's also a link to the Steam page, which is not an affiliate link, but wherever you want to get it, you get it. Oh, and if you want to try it out while we're talking about it, there is also a free demo on Steam, which you can download and test out. One cool thing about that software is that there is a gigantic list of compatible games for that software, but it's not compatible directly to Beam Eye Tracker, but to OpenTrack, with which you need to use the Beam Eye Tracker in order to be able to send that data to these games. So the Beam Eye Tracker software is one thing, but OpenTrack is the other that you need to install. And this is an open source software. And OpenTrack supports more than 200 games, which you can check out on the Beam Eye Tracker website. If you're installing the Beam Eye Tracker software, there's a small little window appearing on your desktop. So there's the software in the right lower corner of your window. And as you see there, it is already tracking my eyes. You can calibrate that entire thing by clicking on calibrate. Then you gotta look for these points. You look at them, you click at them, and then it's done. And your eyes are actually now calibrated. If we're going into the calibration of this entire thing, you see that there are a few different options in general here. There is the gaming extension, which needs to be enabled if you want to use that for games. And there is a head and a head and gaze tracking. What does that mean? Head tracking does only allow you to track your head, the movement left and right and where whatsoever. Head and gaze enables that your eyes are also moving where the camera should move. Now I enabled the eye tracking software, and this is basically an overlay on top of your screen, which you can also see for yourself. Like right now I'm looking at things and it's like kind of okay. You can hide the overlay for recording and streaming. There are not only these gaming things that you can use, but there are also productivity options in the Beam Eye Tracker software, like for example a multi-screen pointer. So this is kind of nice. Like you can have the mouse going to the screen that you're actually looking at. Especially if you're like some kind of, I don't know, a broker with like six screens and you're constantly searching your mouse, you can just put that on center, enable the multi-screen pointer, and whenever you look at another screen, your mouse is always centered on that screen, which is extremely cool. Mouse jumping is a neat thing. You're just looking at where your mouse should go, and then your mouse actually moves where you're looking at. This is actually really cool. You just press a hotkey, and your mouse is exactly where you look at. I'm going to disable that again. Then there's presence detection, system lock, timeout. After, like, let's say 1 second, let's say that I'm going to go away. You see that? And the screen is protected. Especially nice if you're working in an environment where you need to be safe and you just constantly forget to lock your screen. This is a thing that's maybe good for productivity too. So you can actually lock that system when you're not looking at it. There you go. So as you see, it's not only about gaming, it's also about productivity, which is kind of nice. You can of course set up the camera here. There's me. Hi. This is the camera. This is the camera next to the webcam I'm using right now. There is the camera placement, which you need to set up at first. So it will also see which and how many screens you're using, where they are placed. It will take the information from Windows. Camera tilt degree is also pretty important to like get the calibration right. There are some hotkeys like mouse jumping, but there are more hotkeys available in OpenTrack, which we're going to take a look at right now. The link to OpenTrack is also in the description down below. And these two are the companions you need. It works. There's the gaming extension and whatsoever. And now we're going to take as an input the eyewear beam, and we're going to take as an output the 3-track 2.0 enhanced. This works with the most games, as I found out. Sometimes it's free track, sometimes it's UDP over network, maybe some other games or apps use stuff like Flight Gear, Joystick Emulation, Microsoft FSX, SimConnect, or whatsoever. And then you start the software and it's actually working already, as you see. I have set already the curves here, and I did some yaw, pitch, and roll curves for my gaming needs, which are actually really nice because I can't move my entire head like away. And also the tracking does not really work that well if you're like facing completely away. It really depends on what you need. Like I said, there are more options. There are more shortcuts that you can put in OpenTrack. Like for example, recenter. Stopping and starting tracking is really important. Sometimes you just want to look at things and not have tracking enabled. I just disable the tracking. I just do something or whatever. I'm just taking note or whatsoever. So that was quickly setting up the Beam eye tracking software with OpenTrack. But how does it work with the phone? I told you about the phone and the possibility to take that as your webcam. And I'm going to plug the phone in right now and take a look. So right now I just connected my phone with the USB cable. I can tap on my USB settings and I can say webcam on Android. I can go into the Beam eye tracking software, go into settings camera, and then I can use Android webcam, preview the video. Oh wow, there's the webcam. So now we're going to put underneath the monitor 20 degrees upwards, save that. Here we are, I did all the things. Now we're going to recenter and there it is. It works with my phone. My phone is now using the head tracking. As you see, this is set up to webcam, and that webcam is now being used for the head tracking device. All I gotta do is now put that somewhere so that the webcam sees me, and there it is. Head tracking works. Just so you know that I'm not cheating, this is the cap for the webcam. I'm putting the webcam cap on it. It's closed. There you go. And you can still see, oh my God, there. You can still see the little thing moving around. There you go. Can you see this? Still moving around. There you go. A little bit of setup. This is very, very basic. Just a two minute setup of my camera webcam, but it does work. For iOS users, there is a Beam Eye Tracker iOS app that actually benefits from offloading and even 3D sensor tracking from your iPhone. So if you got an iPhone, a latest iPhone with the 3D head tracking feature, the Beam Eye Tracker iOS app actually uses that and makes it even more efficient. So the best webcam that you actually can use for this thing is an iPhone, which I don't have. I got an Android, but it still works. A small tip right here, the higher the FPS is that your webcam can output up to 120 FPS, that's the limit, the better will be the tracking result since you have more data points for your tracking. Good, we're now in X4 where I wanted to show you the head tracking. The first thing we need to do is like go into your settings, into controls and enable the OpenTrack support. There is an OpenTrack connection established. Once you set up head tracking properly in game, and I have put all the necessary buttons on my joysticks, like for example, recentering, boom, recentered. Now it's working weird. Now I need to look into the middle again, boom, recenter. It works really well. I also got stop tracking and start tracking buttons. And when we're flying around now, I'm centering my vision. Now let's have a look at one of these asteroids. Maybe you will find out which asteroid I'm looking at. I can keep that thing in my vision right there. See that? Once you get used to this, and your vision and your ship are actually not necessarily aligned anymore, but you can disconnect that from each other. This is such a game changer, especially in dogfights where you're flying around and you need to take like care of where your opponent is. Look, there is the asteroid that I was looking at, facing the asteroid, flying around the asteroid, looking at the asteroid while my ship is flying somewhere else. Absolutely a game changer in my opinion, absolutely. Now, every single game works a little bit different with head tracking, and every single app also works a little bit different with head tracking. So you gotta see where are the limitations, where are the benefits that you can use in Elite Dangerous, for example, in the next game. You will see that we got a completely different utilization of head tracking that other games are not going to provide you. Maybe like in Elite Dangerous, where you look at specific parts of the ship and it's like opening up a menu, which I will show you right now. Now, I opened up Elite Dangerous and there is nothing happening. Why that? Because Elite Dangerous does not use UDP over network, so we have to go back into OpenTrack, stop that entire thing, and change the output to FreeTrack 2.0 Enhanced, start it, and look what's happening. This is it. We have some inverted views, left and right is fine, but the other views are inverted, so what are we gonna do? We're going into the options, going into output, and pitch needs to be inverted. That's one click, go to OK, and now it's working upward, downward. It's working OK again. In games like Elite Dangerous, for example, if you're looking at a panel there, you can then use the panel. I have not set up my camera for Elite Dangerous. I have set it up for X4, if I'm honest. You saw that it was working a lot better. So I would change the curves and everything for Elite Dangerous. But that would work since I could just do a new profile, empty a new configuration, create a new configuration, set this to Elite Dangerous, and this Elite Dangerous profile would then also have a completely new mapping. As you see, I could go completely different here with the mapping as I did with X4, have it like a lot more aggressive, for example. And now you have, oh my god, you see that? A lot more aggressive without changing too much. Without changing too much, it is already different. So yeah, one more time, Beam Eye Tracker, like I said, thank you very much for sponsoring this video. It's $30 or 30 euros if you buy this on the website through my affiliate link, or if you buy it directly on Steam. It's the same product, though the affiliate link will also support the channel a little bit. It's fairly easy to set up than other options I have seen, like for example, free options that I have seen, and especially the head and eye tracking feature at the same time, or only head tracking or only eye tracking. That works really well with that software. It's AI based. It is being worked on, actively worked on So it should only get better in the future with all the AI stuff that's happening at the moment. Or like I said, you can use it with your Android phone without any app. You can use it with your iPhone with even better improvements with the iOS app. You can use it with every single webcam. So I would say after getting like all the gear that is like really high quality and whatsoever, that one step to eye tracking on top of that really changed the game for me again. But yeah, now let me know what you think about these eye tracking devices. If you're using Beam Eye Tracker, or if you're using something else, I really wouldn't like to know. Also leave a like and subscribe as always to support this channel completely for free, and see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.